Logic is one of the cleanest DAWs I've ever heard when it comes to mixing and sound selection. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to mix your beat like this. Okay, so most of it is sound selection. Now, sound selection and Logic means something different than in other DAWs that I've seen. Sound selection and Logic, the pre-made library sounds, they come with pre-made effects chains as well. So there's delays, there's EQs sometimes, there's reverb. So the sound is really built already for you and mixed for you. It's also even has a reverb chain sometimes built in. So literally every decision-making process is already made for you. So that's why the sounds are so clean in Logic. But if you wanted to investigate the sounds, for the strings here, we're just using a reverb. This is... I pushed the sound back into the background by adding reverb. So if I take this off, the strings are like right in front of us. But I added a reverb to push the sounds as if they're a wall of sound. And now they're not in the forefront, they're like pushed all the way to the back. And all I did was just add a simple reverb at 100% wet level and a little pre-delay just to time it behind other stuff. And just, you could change the size of the room. Pretty simple, just adding a reverb at 100%. That's all we're doing directly on the sound. Let's unlock some other sounds we have here. We have, this one sounds pretty basic. Okay, so all it has here is a reverb. And on this reverb, the main difference here, I have a long haul reverb as the preset, but the main difference is that I have a pitch shifter after the reverb. So I'm slowing down the reverb response. And what this creates is like a high pitch and then a low pitch effect. So it goes, and then it goes at the same time. And that's the reverb playing the lower note. So that's how I create that haunted type of sound like that. Now you can also blend that effect in if you don't want all of your sound to be occupied by that effect. But in this case, I ran all of the sound through the reverb and then the pitch slow effect. So that's a unique sound that I've created. If I take off the pitch shift, just reverb. But here's with the pitch effect. So now it thickens up the sound. It adds that lower octave that we need. Let's go to the next sound here. I think this sound already had the EQ on it from what I remember. So it's just cutting out highs, which were probably too bright on this sound. And then I added, I think this is already on here. Yeah, I don't use this plugin. This is just a delay. So it's just bouncing around. Nothing complex there. But then we're sending it to that same process, which has the reverb and then the pitch effect after. So now all these elements are creating this dark tone because we have two tones. We have the original sound and then we have that slowed down reverb sound. So all these are starting to layer to create their own counter melody underneath. And that string in the background is just the wall that everything's sitting upon. Okay, so sound by sound, it's going to change per song. So I'm just showing you what this record has. Tape delay is another cool effect that you could add to Alchemy just to switch stuff up. This is on the bass. And what people overlook on the tape delay is there's a spread knob right here under character, and it widens out the sound. Here's without that effect. It's just like dead center and it's kind of boring. And with spread, it takes it from left to right phase or left to right panning delay. So it creates that width. Next up, we have Celtic strings. Now this has a lot of processing. I don't think I added this on here, the tremolo. I may have, I don't recall adding that. Maybe I did because I pitched this down. I have a pitch shifter. Let's turn these off, see what it's starting material is. Actually, yeah, I remember adding these plugins now because I remember the sound was a little too happy sounding. I said, how can I make the sound ghetto? So I added a tremolo. And it's doing left to right panning, okay, on the tremolo. And then from here, we're moving into a pitch shifter to, again, match all that lower energy from the other instruments. So pitch shifting, and then we're moving into a compressor just to even it out a bit. Now, one setting I really like about the Logic compressor is this soft clipper. It just sounds crazy good. And I'll show you how to use that on your entire beat. Nextly, we just have a simple delay, again, using that spread knob to widen out things to kind of give it that left-right time difference. And that's what Dr. Dre used to do a lot, is that left or right time. Like, sounds used to go like from left to right back in the day. It was a lot of left to right panning in a lot of older records. Then we have the African patch. Again, I'm starting to run all the sounds through that bus that has that slowed down reverb. Everything else is kind of default here. Now, the real key here is the drum. So I'm running the drums through a soft clipper, but it's in the compressor. So if you open up a compressor, it's right here. It says distortion, soft. And then I turn my threshold to zero so that the compressor is not doing anything. And then I push the drums going into the compressor. So I'm using the soft clip function of the compressor. Same thing with Ableton. It has, in the glue compressor, there's a, I forget the exact knob name, but in the glue compressor, if you turn off the compressor, there's something on that right side, I forget exactly what it's called, maybe soft clip or clip, and it's the same concept. So here's before, let's just bypass. Drums is like, then after it's like, so I'm pushing 18 dB into this soft clipper. Now, it's probably just because the drums are low to begin with, but you can push pretty heavy into it. And that is 90% of the sound is that soft clipper. Nextly, we're moving into this bass. Simple widening effect is just adding chorus to widen out a mono bass. Now on the stereo out, we have this compressor again, and then I'm just soft clipping the output. I'm not boosting because I already pushed the drums. It's just anything that goes above a certain point will get that texture of the soft clipper. And I'm not using compression on this. And this is just one in like, you know, a few beats that I've made. Let me mute my mic and play this track. So if you want another, like, let's say you're in a different DAW, you're watching this video. This isn't specifically for Logic. This SSL imager is actually on sale, I think. So you guys can grab it from, I think, Plug and Boutique. Highly worth it. I have the $2,000 SSL Fusion. I can tell you this module is very close to the real sound. I was actually shocked how good the plugin was. And I was like, wow, it's so much easier using the plugin. But so the stereo imager is definitely worth the 30. Again, I paid $2,000 for the actual SSL Fusion analog unit. Okay, so or the outgear unit. So what we're gonna do is, if your beat isn't wide enough, you can pull up what's called space. And this is gonna boost 280 to 220-ish of frequencies on the sides. And this is gonna widen out without pulling the entire track wide. So this is a cool technique for drill and trap in darker genres, because you're pulling out those lower frequencies. Now for this track, it's already wide, but I'll kind of show you how far you can push it. So to demonstrate this, I'm going to solo the sides. You hear all that low frequency information. So if I pull this down, we're going to hear less low frequency information. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just widen this out. Now for this track, it's already wide. If you widen an already widened sound, this is going to sound messy. So you don't really need it that much on this track. I just wanted to mention it because I saw it went on sale, and it's a perfect time to grab this plugin. I'm not sponsored by them. This is a very close plugin to the analog, or should I say outgear, that I had, the SSL Fusion. So if your song feels mono, use this. Or feels very stale, use this. We'll be right back. Let's A-B the effect. So here's before. Here's after. Now you got to be careful with the levels here because now we're clipping. So I'm going to put the stereo imager before our compressor. So that way we're not clipping. Also, we're going to watch the output here. More sterile without it. Again, this track already had width, so I'm not going to overly push, but try that plugin. I guarantee you're going to like the sound. Thank you for watching. It's Gabe from busyworksbeats.com. If you want to learn more about mixing, go to premium.busyworksbeats.com. Look for the mixing fundamentals course. I'll leave it below. Peace.